Okay, hello guys. I know this might not be the most orthodox place to start the third video, but this is the event after the hot spring. And after Altus's diary entry, which is all at the end of chapter 2, by the way. So we're not technically in chapter 3 yet. See? Altus is still writing in her diary. The end of chapter 2 is quite lengthy. And chapter 3 doesn't actually start until you talk to Ryuto and go to Moonworld. But before you talk to Ryuto, again, you want to make sure that you take Sol and Sandy out of your party. Also, me, I've been working on getting 600% peons. Peons with 600% aptitudes, which is something I'll say for another video. Once I actually get it to closer to 600, that way I can gauge how much time it takes to actually pull this off. Because so far I'm only at 100% so far, like around 110% really. And I've been through the game about 3 times with them in the back. So it takes a while, yeah. I'll go over it in more detail, but for right now, before we can actually get on to Moonworld, we are faced with Valeria's ship. Again, we just easily destroy it with our crazy overpowered G-Castle. Like, I literally overkilled Valeria's ship like 500 times over. Probably a lot more, 500,000 times over. What you should get from that is, we beat Valeria, and now she boarded our ship. Which of course means we will have to fight her. Now, the fight with Valeria, I think it's this one, but there is one where if you try to fight Valeria and Moe kill the large crystal, it'll end up frenzying it no matter what. I'm not sure if it's this one. I know it happens. I know it definitely happens in chapter 10. Which, by the way, chapter 10's episode is going to be very long. I'll go ahead and warn you guys now. That's where you have to go through the 60th floor of the Mugen field, so yeah, fun to be had there. Yeah, it was this one. As you saw, the large crystal's frenzy meter shot way up. And Shushu's charm level is 67, so that shouldn't be happening. So, whatever you do during that fight, avoid the large crystal at all costs. At all fights. Blah. Good English. But yes, don't try to Moe kill the large crystal, it'll only make you sad. But the small crystals, yes. But I would focus on Moe killing the birds in Valeria. Now, we could open up Mugen Field right now, but I'm gonna go ahead and start Moon World. And yes, the loading is absolutely painful. And when you first land on the first continent of Moon World, you want to make sure to pick up that Master Point. It's kind of easy to miss, and we're going to run into a forced encounter here. But of course, with tutorials. Teaching us about peon commands, but I don't need to know about that. Just need peons. 75 of 2 types, iron and coral. Which is always welcome. All Alright, yeah, after the fight there's a dialogue scene, so you want to make sure to skip that too. And before you trigger this event, make sure to pick up this Master Point too. It's also a little easy to miss because it's side of the building. And those are the only two bothersome events. Sorry, Master Points. And then, no forced encounter here, this is just lots of dialogue. And the introduction to Tsukika. Right, I haven't mentioned it, but this is one of the few continents where you actually will be able to 300% moe kill on your first visit. This one's a forced encounter with an event before it. I'll defeat you. And I think there's one after it. Sorry, I can't remember if there was. But again, just Peon kill them, or Moe kill them, sorry. This time we get 120 worn out drill and pop guns, so, woo! Bring in the Shampoos. Alright, now, the path I'd like to take is going this way. Yeah, B's in a bad spot this time. Usually I don't have to worry about him. Alright, we want to pick up this Master Point. It will make sense. It'll make sense after these next few events. But yeah, after you pick up that Master Point, don't worry about anything else. Just run into this radish here. Dang. I don't know, enemy placements, it's pretty random. Like, their spawning point isn't random, but where they walk around, it's kind of tough. Sometimes you just have to fight them. Like that bee, he's pretty easy to dodge. The flower is pretty easy to dodge as well. Now, you're going to want to trigger this scene, and don't forget that there's a scene that triggers if you backtrack a little too. That's when access to more Master Points will open up. So try not to waste any time in triggering that last event. And of course, Shirogane trembles at the mention of Tsukika's name. So real quick, there's the event I was talking about. Make sure you don't run into the flower. This one is a model event followed by dialogue. Yep, he's one with the stars. She actually sent him to the next continent. Bad Tsukika, you make us do more work. And she also unofficially joins our party. I say unofficially because she doesn't fight with us. Sadly. At least not yet. Okay, so now we can work on 300%ing this continent. Okay, I'll go around since the flower's in the way. We can pick up two master points in this area. That gold one. And there's one next to the bench, next to the tree. But of course, after we moe kill only one master point, we get the results and our free shampoos. Which is the whole reason we're doing this in the first place. Alright, here's the bench I was talking about. Once you moe kill these two master points, you can confidently march on. remember that split I was talking about earlier? We're going to take the master point right here and quickly run to our right. Avoid the radish and pumpkin head. And there are three master points here. Sorry, I didn't see which one that was. Okay. Go ahead, dump 1,000 on that. Run to the kunais here. We have sufficient amount of kills. And lastly, the shuriken over here. And done. 300%. See? And the save crystal to leave. All in a timely fashion. Now, if you were to take the weapons path first, you wouldn't be able to get all three of those master points. And you would have to go around to still get the Heaven's Gate, the master point near the Heaven's Gate. So I think the path that I took is, I think that's the best path to take. It's most efficient. You don't have to do any backtracking. Well, you have to do very minor backtracking. But that's the path I really like to take. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and open up the Mugen field now. Make sure you skip the event. Yay, Sophina! And more explanatory shampoo, because the world can't get enough of him. Man, loading is pretty bad. I have the game installed and I don't know, is there something I'm doing wrong? Should I blow on my disc before I start all the time? Should I do some magic dance to make it work harder? Anyways, second continent here. We are greeted with two events straight off the bat. This is the first one, it's kinda long. Where, basically to wrap it up, Tsukika punches a boulder. Chris Redfield cannot compare. Yeah, I've been through this game. I've been through this story so many times. I actually remember where all the master points are. I know where they all are. Like, I can find them all without missing any. It's pretty crazy. I've actually learned master point locations. I don't even need to use the video I made for that. Because actually when I made that video, that's when I actually learned where they all were. Because before, like in my 5th and 6th runs, I was like, oh man, I wish I knew where they all were. Because I had to do so much running around and stupid time wasting, but now, no, not anymore. Now I know where they all are, and it's happy times for me. Oh, also, I didn't mention it before, but the second continent of Moonworld, we cannot get 300% or even 100% for our troubles. So sorry guys, no new shampoos. At least not from the continents. But there is a problem in the boss fight that I'm going to point out that I ran into a lot. Maybe you guys will be a bit luckier than me. Hopefully, because I had some really bad luck in my run-throughs. So hopefully you can learn from my horrible, horrible upbringings. Just like this. The way that the carrot was positioned, it was absolutely horrible. I had no chance of getting around him, so I had to fight him. Which is bad news for him, of course. Because now he works for me. And we get Pop Gun, Iron, and Corporal. All good Champurus. But the reason we came down there was for that Master Point. And I think there's going to be about two more Master Points we can get. No, I think three. There's this one, which we're going to want to put 200 down for. And then this one right here, which is Smash X. Ah, right, the event. And then that dumb bird that blocks an extra... the last Master Point for us, actually. Skip, 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 skip. Yeah, we had to come comfort I almost called her Rorona. She has Rorona's voice actress, but she is Tsukika. Her name is Tsukika. Okay, leave us alone, Eagle Bird. Alright, this is the last Master Point we can only kill. This visit through. The bird is terrorizing me and I can't get away! Whew! Oh my gosh. Okay, anyways. This is the last event for the chapter. Well, last event area. Whatever you want to call it. You know, last field event. Because this is where we fight Shirogane. And Shirogane's battleship. All because Valeria's charm level wasn't high enough to make Shirogane her peon. So she accidentally frenzied him and made him stronger. We need to teach Valeria a lesson. We need to show her how to make proper peons. Because Shushu can. Shushu is amazing. Shushu is overwhelming. Lady Shushu is life. If you want a job on G Castle, all flyers are available at the front. And go home, Shirogane, you clearly stood no chance. And we get Dust Bunnies and Chestnut Heads for that. Funny story, if you saw my, I think it was my first bonus video, you'll know that Chestnut Head was actually the first shampoo type that I maxed out. So, I actually don't benefit from getting Chestnut Heads. Sadly. Alright, now for this battle, you want to be careful with Shirogane. His Moe is bipolar. So, at lower ego levels, you won't be able to Moe kill him. You'll only be able to item kill him. So, make sure you either Moe kill the large crystal or change your forms accordingly. I think Moe killing the crystal is the safest way to go. Because if you pick bipolar, and if any one of the enemies is one of the enemies Moe is Ditz, then you won't get the Moe kill. Or if they have ego, and you switch to bipolar, then they're gonna get item killed again. So it's a big mess. And that wraps it up for chapter 2. So I will see you guys for chapter 3. Father. Thanks for watching. Hopefully you've learned something.